Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's ETA Prime back here again with a LaunchBox end of year review. And you know, throughout the year of 2022, we've had a lot of fixes, improvements, changes, and new features added to LaunchBox for Windows and LaunchBox for Android. In fact, we've actually had 8 major releases of LaunchBox for Windows, 7 major releases of LaunchBox for Android, and along with that, the community has also come through with a lot of custom content. We had 7 new LaunchBox themes. Now I'm talking about LaunchBox, and when it comes to big box themes, there was 31 new ones released in 2022, and 9 for LaunchBox for Android. So the community has definitely been pumping out some awesome content, whether it comes to the Android version of LaunchBox or the Windows version of LaunchBox and Big Box. And we really can't thank you enough, so we definitely want to send out a big thank you to the whole community. And by the end of this video, I will go through a list of some of the major contributors, but like I mentioned, I mean, we've had a lot of releases of LaunchBox for Windows and Android in 2022. And in this video, we're going to go over the major features that have been added throughout the year. Starting off in February of 2022, version 12.7 of LaunchBox for Windows was released, and with this one, we implemented a new feature that would automatically download and configure the MAME emulator for any version of your ROM set. Now this does make it really easy to get your MAME games up and running in LaunchBox, and I've said it in the past, but I do think that LaunchBox is the easiest way to play your MAME games, and especially now with this new feature that was added in 12.7. We also overhauled the LaunchBox Games Details section, giving it a new modern look and adding new features. Plus, with this release, we also added a Documents badge, which would specify if you've downloaded any manuals or extra documents along with your games. And in the same month, LaunchBox for Android version 1.1 was released. Now, it was on a little bit of a hiatus, but it's back for Android. And with version 1.0, we now have support for gameplay videos. These can be downloaded from EMU movies. We've also added support for a lot of different emulators that'll work easily with LaunchBox for Android. And it has support for the new file permission system that Google used with Android 11 and so on and so on. So we can use this with Android 11. We've got a lot of new features with version 1.0. Moving over to March 1st, 2022. This is when LaunchBox version 12.8 for Windows was released. And the MAME importer had a lot of improvements. We actually added a lot of features here to make it even easier to get your games imported and up and running inside of LaunchBox using MAME. With this, you can prioritize different versions of MAME titles that only have 2 or 4 players. So if you know you're not going to be playing the 4-player version of that game, you can only import the 2-player if you wanted to do that. You can also skip games that require CHD files, or skip games altogether that require a certain input method, like let's say a trackball or maybe even a joystick. And along with these new features to the MAME importer, we also added a MAME arcade playlist that was available for vertically orientated games. A lot of people wanted this feature. They were wanting to build a vertical cab or maybe even just swapping their monitor over on its side. And having this implemented was definitely a must. That way we could just get a list of all of our vertical games and we don't have to sort through them manually. Heading into April, on the 27th, LaunchBox version 12.10 was released for Windows. And with this one, we got the new related games feature. This is actually really cool. And in here, we have recommended games, similar games, and possible ports for other systems or consoles. So this makes it really easy to find similar games that you might like to play. And in this same release, we also implemented the LaunchBox Theme Downloader. So this is available in LaunchBox for premium users. And you know, for the longest time, inside of Big Box, we've had the Big Box Theme Downloader. This is very similar, but it allows us to download LaunchBox themes and automatically install them. In the past, we always had to manually install these themes, and we've got a lot to choose from now. You can make your LaunchBox setup look really nice. And when it comes to the Android version of LaunchBox, we released version 1.1 in April of 2022. And with this, we implemented full game editing, which allows us to long press on an individual game, and we can edit its metadata and media individually. So we can kind of customize each game if something's not right, if we want to change the region or something like that. We can do it directly in LaunchBox for Android. And along with this, we also added support for downloading platform theme videos right in LaunchBox for Android. We've got a downloader ready to go. You can actually prioritize what set of platform theme videos you want to download, or you could kind of mix it up and download individual platform themes per system. It's really up to you. LaunchBox version 12.12 was released June 20th, and with this release, we implemented Bezels. So this is actually really awesome. For MAME and RetroArch, while we're importing our games, we can automatically download and set up bezels using the Bezel project. And when it comes to these retro games, you know, a lot of these just ran at a 4:3 aspect ratio, and most of us are using 16:9 displays nowadays. So while on the side, you'll have those black bars, but as you can see here with those bezels implemented, we get a little bit of artwork on the sides to kind of cover that up, and it really does add to the whole experience. Another cool new feature with version 12.12 was the image pack tool. So this actually allows us to easily import image packs that the community creates. So if you wanted a custom pack for, let's say, Nintendo 64 or Game Boy, and it's over on the forum, you can download the zip file, import it into LaunchBox using the new image pack tool, and it'll automatically put everything where it needs to go. And we can't forget about the Android version, because in June, version 1.2 was released, and now we have custom theme support in LaunchBox for Android. And with this one, we also added support for EtherSX2, the PS2 emulator. In the past, it was a bit hard to get this up and running with any front end on Android, but now it's working with LaunchBox for Android, and PSP was also fully fixed using PPSSPP. In July, LaunchBox for Android version 1.4 was released, and with this, we got complete game sorting, so we have tons of filters here, and we've also got a recently played filter that we can go through, so we can actually just go back to the games we've recently played on Android very easily. And unfortunately, in July, we didn't see a major release of LaunchBox for Windows, and that's because something big was being worked on. August 2nd, 2022, version 12.14 of LaunchBox for Windows was released, and with this, we got a total big box overhaul. Memory usage was significantly decreased due to back-end implementations, and startup times are much quicker. Now, in my system, I really notice a difference. I'm still using a mechanical drive for my build of LaunchBox, and startup times are much faster than they were before 12.14. And you know, along with all of these implementations, we got the brand new default theme, which I personally love. I think this looks absolutely amazing. Very minimalistic. We've got that gray design there. I think it's a really nice theme. And it really does give this front end a nice modern look straight out of the box. Now, we've still got access to all of the custom themes over on the forum. We've got our theme downloader still implemented in Big Box, so it's really up to you. But I've personally been using this default theme ever since it was released because I think it looks so awesome. And in the same month of August, LaunchBox for Android version 1.5 was released, and we've got alphanumeric indexing, so we can actually use our controller to go through and alphabetically sort our games. You can also do this from the menu if you'd like to, but it does offer controller support just like Big Box for Windows. Really nice little feature. And along with this, we also made launching screens fully themable, so developers can definitely take advantage of this and come up with some really nice launching screens or startup screens for games that kind of go with the theme you're using. Plus, we added MS-DOS support, and this is actually a really quick and easy way to get MS-DOS games up and running in Android. Really awesome feature. Checking out LaunchBox for Windows September release. This is 12.15. And here we've actually implemented platform details in LaunchBox. So now without a game selected, we've got platform details for our consoles or our systems. We can now also manage our PC game installations directly in LaunchBox. So, you know, if you're using GOG, Steam, Epic Games, or Uplay, we can actually go in here, uninstall, and install games that haven't been installed yet to our PC directly from within LaunchBox. And a big shout out to Dan Patrick from over on the LaunchBox forum, because he does create some awesome clear logos. We've implemented 100 new platform clear logos made by him, and these are really clean. These are totally overhauled, done from scratch, and they look absolutely amazing. Heading into October, we got LaunchBox for Android 1.6, and we now have a theme manager implemented in LaunchBox for Android. So this makes it really easy to get your themes downloaded. We no longer have to download them from the forum, extract them, or even transfer them over from our PC if you did it that way in the past. We also now have platform sorting in LaunchBox for Android. So as you can see on screen now, we've got all of my Nintendo section together. We've got our Sega section together. And along with all of this in 1.6, we also added game-specific media downloads. So you can actually go per game and download new box art. We can swap out the region if you want to. So if you wanted that Japanese box art or the European box art, you could do it per game. And finally here, wrapping up the LaunchBox for Windows releases for 2022, we've got LaunchBox 13. And this is one of my favorite features I've seen in a very long time. 3D box models. So we've got full 3D box models in big box now, and we can actually go through, we can rotate them, we can check out the spines, you can actually add new spines if you want to. And I think this looks incredible, and one of the coolest things here is most existing themes where boxes are deployed, this will work with it without any kind of modification from the theme developer. And we also got this new theme called 3D Dimensions from Farron to kind of show it all off. So this is really tailored towards these new 3D boxes, and it looks great. And the final LaunchBox for Android release came out on December 13th. This is known as LaunchBox for Android 1.7. And we finally got full screen support in Android. So we can get rid of our navigation bar. We can get rid of our notification bar on Android tablets and phones. Plus, we've added platform categories and arcade filters to Android, kind of just like we have with Big Box for Windows. Very similar here, so we can go ahead and sort these out. We can set up platform categories, and we can also set up our arcade filters, so we can make it really easy just to navigate our whole system and find games we want to play. So overall, when it comes to all of the releases in 2022, be it for Android or Windows, I think the developers have done an absolutely amazing job with this software. And along with that, the community has still been really awesome, and a lot of this wouldn't be possible without you guys, so we want to give you a big thank you, and here's some more notable figures from our community. And we definitely hope you enjoy using LaunchBox and Big Box, and keep in mind, even though we've released a lot in 2022, we've got a lot more coming in 2023, so stay tuned. Keep an eye on the YouTube channel and the forum. I'll leave some links in the description. But that's going to wrap it up for 2022. And like always, thanks for watching.